I'm Cheryl and welcome to the Sewing Room channel. I'm going to demonstrate how to make this lady's blouse. What I like about this blouse is it has dolman sleeves. They are really easy to do and they're very, very comfortable. You don't feel bound in. It has this little V-neck right there, which is a really simple process to do that. And it hangs down lower on the sides and comes up more in the front, and it's a nice loose flowing little top, and I made mine out of a very lightweight polyester fabric, and it's just perfect for summer. So let's get started. The name of this pattern is New Look, and the pattern number is D0932. This is the view that I'm making. It's view B. This is what it looks like in the drawing. You can make this same one and just have it going straight across. So it'll be up to you as to which one you want to do. On the back of the envelope, it lists the sizes. It goes extra small to extra large. So it's a multi-size pattern. All of the sizes are listed on the pattern pieces, and I'll show you what I mean by that in a moment. So you want to look at the measurement guide here. Determine which one you are. Also, I also recommend that you hold the pattern pieces up to your body to see if it looks like it's going to fit. So here is view B right here. Here is the amount of fabric you will need according to the size. It will also list at the bottom the type of fabric that they suggest you use. If you're not sure what size you are, there is a way you can measure yourself. So there's a chart printed on your pattern piece that will tell you where your bust line is, your waist, and your hips. So these are the areas that you measure. On your pattern, you'll see all of these lines. This is extra small down to extra large. So you would select whatever line represents your size, and that's the line you cut on. Now I'm going to be doing the medium size. If you want, you can highlight, use a highlighter and highlight the line so you make sure you don't cut on the wrong line. To lay your pattern pieces out, refer to the instruction sheet to the layout section. This is view B, and this is the layout if you have 44 to 45 inch wide fabric, and this is the layout if you have a 58 to 60 inch wide fabric. And up here it tells you what pieces you need to use to make this top. I'm doing this layout here. When you lay your pieces down, this shaded one means that this piece is laid upside down. That's what the shading means. So you look through the tissue paper that this is printed on, and you're looking at the letters backwards. This little piece here, you cut out after you've cut these two pieces out, and you unfold your leftover piece of fabric and lay this on the bias. As you look at your pattern pieces, there'll be a line going right where the waist area is. If you need to adjust the length or to make it longer or shorter, that's where you adjust it. I'm very short, so I folded my pattern at that area till I got it to the length that I wanted. As you move down towards the bottom of each pattern piece, you will see another solid line. If you are doing the view C, where the bottom of the shirt is straight across, this is where you would cut. I recommend you don't cut the pattern, you just fold it back. That way, at a later date, if you want to make this view, you haven't lost that piece. Place your pattern down on top of your fabric. Remember, your fabric is folded with the selvage edges together. So you're going to be cutting through two layers of fabric because you need two. two pieces for the, you need two pieces for the front and the back. This piece here is the one that's laid in reverse, and it's closer to the folded edge. The other piece down here, which this is labeled pattern number, or piece number 7, this other one was piece number 6, this one is laid closer to the selvage edge. There's a straight line with an arrow on it on both pieces. That means you want to keep it on the straight grain of fabric. So the straight grain is your threads in your fabric go this way and they go this way. Bias is going across both angles of thread. So you want to make sure pattern piece 6 and 7 are placed on the straight grain. Then over here, you have your little piece that's cut on the bias. So make sure that you wait, you cut pattern piece 6 and 7 out first, then you unfold this fabric and lay it out on the bias. I like to use weights to hold my pattern pieces down. You can pin your pieces down, but I find that it sort of distorts the fabric a little bit when using straight pins. So you can use straight pins and then use scissors to cut it out, or use straight pins and a rotary cutter. But I like my weights because I get great accuracy. So you have two different options for cutting it out. So I'm going to place my weight close to the edge of the pattern piece and just go along cutting it out. If you're using a rotary cutter, make sure you keep your fingers away from the blade. Before you unpin your pattern from your fabric, you need to look for all of the little symbols that are used for matching your fabrics together and or stitching from one point to another. So on this front pattern piece, pattern number 6, you're going to find little notch symbols here in the armpit area, in the front center seam, and you'll also see some little circle dots here, and you'll see a notch up here at the shoulder. On your front center seam, you'll see two little notches. There are these little triangle shapes. And you're going to put two dots there on one fabric piece, then flip it over and put two dots there. This is used for matching your pieces together. Then over here where you see these little circles, look for your size. I'm doing a size medium. I'm going to go straight out to the edge and do the same thing. Put a little dot, I'm using a fabric marker, and put a dot on the other side. And then up here you'll see another set of dots. They're circles. I'm going to look for my size again, medium. I'm going to go open it up and put a dot on this side fabric piece and then on the other fabric piece. So look over your entire pattern, both front and back, and look for those notches and dots and mark them. Look on your pattern sheet instructions for the section that talks about tunic B and C. Here are the pieces that you're going to be working on next. They're telling you to do something called stay stitch stitching up here at the neckline area on all four pieces. You do the stay stitching stitch, that's to prevent the neckline area from stretching while you are sewing. I like to lengthen my stitch, and I'll change the length to 3.0, and you're only going to stitch maybe a slightly more than 1/8 of an inch from the edge on all four fabric pieces. The next step is they're talking about pattern piece number 6, and you're going to be stitching the front seam together. Now I'm going to give you several choices. You can either, if you have a serger, you can serge the raw edge of your fabric pieces before you stitch them together, or you can serge both pieces together, which is what I'm going to do. But on your front piece, don't serge all the way up. Remember those little dots we marked? So that one below the little V, this is going to be a V-neck here. So you're going to stitch from that dot on your fabric all the way down to the bottom. If you did not serge your edges together on both pieces, then press this center seam open. We're still on the front center seam. If you serged your two pieces together on that center seam, make sure you leave a few inches that are not serged together, because you want to fold the opening. You're going to have a little V-neck shape. So you're going to fold your edges back on the inside 5/8 of an inch. Then you're going to fold the raw edge under that and then stitch it down. And I'll show you a sample of that in just a moment. Now we're on pattern piece number 7, which is for the back. So on there, it's showing you to bring front sides together and stitch a 5/8 inch seam. So throughout this top, it's a 5/8 inch seam unless otherwise indicated differently. So on that front piece, make sure it's 5/8 inch seam. Then again, you can either serge your edges together or stitch it here like this and press the seam open. If you serged your edges together, then press your seam all towards one direction. This is my center seam. I told you earlier to run it through a serger if you have one and serge these two edges together. I've changed my mind. I realize this seam needs to be open. So stitch a 5/8 inch seam down the center from the bottom edge up to where your little dot or your little marking is. After stitching the center seam, press the seam open all the way down. Then up here at your little V-neck opening, you're going to take each side of the opening and fold it over 5/8 of an inch and press it along there. Then fold this edge under and press again. And you do that on both sides of your opening. I recommend that you place pins along here to hold it down before you begin stitching. And then stitch close to the edge here and stitch from the back side. Come down about 1/4 inch past the little opening here. Stitch across and then stitch back up this side. Now, whenever you come to a corner so that you don't lose your place, always leave your needle down through the fabric, lift up your presser foot, and then turn the fabric. Here it is from the front side so you can see what it should look like. Then once you're done stitching, go ahead and press all of this flat. Here is the back seam. Now on this one, I serged my edges together all the way down. Now for those of you who don't have a serger, select one of your overcast stitches on your sewing machine. If you're not sure what those are, check your user's manual for the correct stitch. Here is that center back seam from the front side. And remember to press your seam, and if you've closed the seam up, in other words, you serged both edges together, then just press your seam all in one direction. If not, press the seam open. Bring both sides of the blouse together. So you're bringing front sides together and lay them on top of each other and line your edges up at the shoulder seam. Go ahead and pin your fabric together. Then you're either going to serge your seams up here or do a 5/8 inch seam. So stitch along this edge and then over to this edge and then press your seams. After you stitch the shoulder seam together, on your instruction sheet, it refers you to go to View A to finish off the neck area. This is section View A, and it wanted you to do steps 5, 6, and 7. So bring the ends of your binding strip, that's pattern piece number 3, bring the ends front sides together and stitch a 5/8 inch seam. Then you're going to fold the unnotched edge. So you have a notched edge. That's where I had you do those little markings. So you're going to go to the unnotched edge and fold it up 3/8 of an inch. Then you're going and press it. Then go to your neck area and pin it to the neck area, aligning up all of your notches. When you're placing the band onto the neck, you want to place the dots right there on the edge of the opening. So here's, I'm going to open this up this way so you can see where the opening of my little V-neck is. So you match that edge with the dots on your band. When you're pinning this down, you're actually going to stretch the band a little bit because it's not going to be an exact fit and it's supposed to be that way. So just stretch it a little bit. And as you are sewing, you're going to just slightly stretch until the band fabric straightens out. You're going to stitch a 3/8 inch wide seam all the way around. Sometimes when you're making clothing and you're following someone else's pattern instructions, you realize it's not quite the best way to do something. So sometimes I just take it upon myself to change it because I want it to be the easiest way for you. And this next step, I'm going to show you what they say in there and what they don't say. After you stitched it on, they recommended that you just fold this edge over to the back and then stitch it down. But I realize it's going to look really lumpy and bumpy. I don't like that method. So then I thought, okay, I'm going to clip this because little clips around the neckline area in the seam only. And that's going to help a little bit. It's going to lay nicer because it'll stretch. But it's still going to be lumpy and bumpy. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave it up to you as to which method you want to follow. From about, a half inch over from each side of this edge here, I'm going to trim the width of the seam down just a little bit. It's going to make it easier to fold this over. So then you could go in and do little clips along there, and that's going to help it lay down and look a lot smoother and more professional. Now I'm ready to fold the binding over the seam. So in the instructions, it says to just fold it over like that. And you want to bring this folded edge past the stitch line because you're going to be stitching this down from the front side. So you want to make sure that this is pulled past the stitch line and then go ahead and pin it down. Now turn it over to where the front side is facing up. Check the width of the band to make sure it's been folded the same distance. For instance, this is folded slightly wider than in other areas. So you need to make adjustments. Go ahead and recheck and replace your pins if necessary. Once you've got everything ready to go, the instruction sheet says to stitch on top of the binding close to this edge. Now you'll notice that I pinned from the back. I have a hand issue, so sometimes I have to do things in an unorthodox way than from everybody else. So you can pin it from the front. I'm pinning it from underneath and I have my own little way of removing those pins. So go ahead and do your stitching all the way around. Bring front sides of the garment together and pin your side seams and either serge your edge or stitch a 5/8 inch seam from the bottom all the way around to the end of the sleeve area. So stitch both side seams. If you look at your pattern piece itself, On the pattern piece at the sleeve, it says that it's a 1-inch width hem. So you would fold it up 1 inch. On the instruction sheet, it says to fold your raw edge to the back side, and then you would fold it up 3/4 of an inch and then stitch it down. I'm going to serge my edge and then fold it up just once, and I'm going to use a twin needle. If you want to know how to use a twin needle, check below your YouTube screen for that video link. The lower hem at the bottom of the blouse is a 5/8 inch wide seam. So they're saying to fold it up and press the width of 5/8 inch, and then you would fold the other edge underneath it and then stitch along this inside folded edge. Just follow those instructions. But for me, I'm going to serge the bottom edge, and then I'm going to fold it up and then use a twin needle to stitch it down. When doing your hem at the bottom of the blouse, one thing I want to point out to you, in the two side corners, you want to fold one side over and then stitch it. Then go to the other side and fold it over and stitch it. When you're done, this is what those two side corners look like. This is the front side, and then this is on the inside. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you're interested in learning how to make other clothing items, check below your YouTube screen for those video links. And also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and make sure you check out my Facebook page. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy sewing. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click on the thumbs up button. Don't forget to click on share to share this video with your friends. If you haven't subscribed yet, click on that red subscribe button down there in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Don't forget to click on the bell. I'm Cheryl, and this is a lot of manis. See you next time, and happy sewing!